गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास। आफ्टर एसिड बेस साल्ट, प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ साल्ट, फैमिली ऑफ साल्ट, नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट ब्लीचिंग पाउडर, बेकिंग सोडा, जिप्सम, प्लास्टर एंड मीन्स मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ ब्लीचिंग पाउडर, मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ बेकिंग सोडा, प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ बेकिंग सोडा, प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ब्लीचिंग पाउडर एंड देयर यूजेस। फर्स्ट वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम ब्लीचिंग पाउडर। बट ऑल ऑफ यू सी, ब्लीचिंग पाउडर इज अ कैल्शियम ऑक्सीक्लोराइड। मीन्स ब्लीचिंग पाउडर इज, ऑल ऑफ यू नो, वी यूज ब्लीचिंग पाउडर इन स्टरलाइजिंग वाटर, मीन्स क्लीनिंग ऑफ वाटर। Right now, we use bleaching powder in cotton industries. We use bleaching powder in paper industries, and we use bleaching powder as a oxidizing agent. Means these are the uses of bleaching powder, and this. In last when question will come that right, the usage of bleaching powder, then you write these usages. Now, preparation of bleaching powder means manufacture of bleaching powder, in which way we will prepare, in which way we will manufacture the bleaching powder. Now see, first you see, bleaching powder is calcium oxychloride is there. Bleaching powder is calcium oxychloride. Their formula is CaOCl2. Or Ca in bracket OCl into Cl, right now, and it is also called chlorine of lime. Means the another name of bleaching powder is chlorine of lime. Chlorine of lime means, you know that we manufacture bleaching powder with the help of. Are we use in manufacture of bleaching powder lime. Now see, preparation of bleaching powder. Bleaching powder, when calcium hydroxide means slagged lime, I told you know that another name is chlorine of lime. Lime is chuna. Now calcium hydroxide means when slagged lime react with solid slagged lime react with solid chlorine, we will get calcium. The product is calcium oxychloride, and this calcium oxychloride is bleaching powder, plus we get water. But when you want to increase the manufacture of bleaching powder, means when you want to get in a broad way and sufficient amount of, means accept laboratory lab outside in industries, then same process will be there, but at 35 degrees Celsius, means in which we manufacture bleaching powder, you see slagged lime at 35 degrees Celsius, at 35 degree temperature, when you give 35 degrees temperature, at 35 degree temperature, calcium oxide, calcium hydroxide means slagged lime, solid slagged lime react with solid chlorine, their product is bleaching powder and water. In this way we prepare bleaching powder. Right now, properties of bleaching powder, first properties. In properties of bleaching powder, first property you see, color of it, yellowish white, means safed halke pilo, yellowish white color powder is there, and here is a chlorine is there. Due to the chlorine or in presence of chlorine, their odor is, means smell, very strong smell is there. Means in bleaching powder you will get the strong smell of chlorine. After that, second properties you see that solubility in water. Bleaching powder is soluble in water, but in bleaching powder, slagged lime, part of slagged lime is there. That's why The unreacted lime means those part of lime is there that present in bleaching powder. That's why little bit insoluble. You see, undissolved means bleaching powder. It is soluble in cold water, but due to the lime, few parts, a few amount of, right now, not dissolving water. After that, exposure to air, bit of wind, bleaching powder react with air, and in air carbon dioxide present there. Then you see what happens when bleaching powder, solid bleaching powder react with carbon dioxide present in air. Then what happens? Slowly, gradually, it loses its chlorine. Means when bleaching powder react with carbon dioxide present in air, what happens? It lose their chlorine. And when it lose their chlorine, it form calcium carbonate, solid calcium carbonate, and release chlorine gas. It release chlorine gas. And third properties with acid. With acid. Third properties of bleaching powder with acid. Beta, when bleaching powder react with any acid, what happen? It decompose. It decompose and it give off of chlorine gas. Means when bleaching powder react with acid, what happen? It give off. Give off means it release chlorine gas from there. Now see reaction. When bleaching powder calcium oxychloride react with dilute HCl hydrochloric acid, what happen? Calcium chloride is there, water is there, and chlorine is there. Here beta, I told you that it give off, it release their chlorine. It release their chlorine, you know beta, this chlorine move outside and the chlorine of acid react with and form calcium chloride. You take another example. When bleaching powder react with sulfuric acid, what you get? Calcium sulfate, CaSO4, water, and give off of chlorine. This is the properties of bleaching powder. After that, we will discuss about the baking powder. Baking powder means calcium hydrogen carbonate. Or calcium bicarbonate. The chemical name is the calcium hydrogen carbonate or calcium bicarbonate. Now, we will discuss about the manufacture of calcium hydrogen carbonate means baking soda. After that, their properties. After that, their uses. Baking soda use already, you know that. In bread. Sponge bread is there now. We use that baking powder. When you make puri, we use baking soda. Why? To soft. And sponge is there. Now, let us see about baking soda. Baking soda is just like a powder, same as the powder, right? Now, and the chemical name of baking soda is sodium bicarbonate or sodium hydrogen carbonate. You see, baking soda, sodium hydrogen carbonate, NaHCO3, or sodium bicarbonate, NaHCO3. Now, their preparation, you see, in which way you prepared in laboratory. Beta, in lab, we use common salt. You see, we use common salt. You see the preparation of baking soda. How is baking soda prepared? Beta, you see, in laboratory, baking soda can be prepared by saturating a cold solution of sodium carbonate with carbon dioxide. Means in lab, cold solution of sodium carbonate is there, saturated sodium carbonate is there, and carbon dioxide is there. Means when aqueous solution of sodium carbonate react with carbon dioxide and saturated solution means what will be there? What we get sodium bicarbonate, white crystal of sodium bicarbonate, and this white crystal of sodium bicarbonate is, or sodium hydrogen carbonate, is baking soda. Means in lab, saturated solution of sodium carbonate, when it react with carbon dioxide, we get sodium hydrogen carbonate, means white crystal of sodium hydrogen carbonate or sodium bicarbonate. This is the baking soda. Now, if lab is not there, in lab only we use for reaction. But suppose that to supply, because you know that there are broad usage of baking soda. The baking soda first is in bread, we use it in your house. We use in chapatis, puris, and you know that baking soda is antacid in your stomach due to the overeating. As spicy thing is there, when you eat it, what happen inside your stomach, acidity is there, and to neutralize this acid, we use baking soda. Means we use baking soda as antacid. Then the demand is there. Due to demand, we will not prepare, or we are unable to prepare it in laboratory right now. Now, in which way you make a manufacture of baking soda? You see, manufacture of baking soda, it is obtained as intermediate product. Beta, in manufacture, one manufacture of baking soda, that process is called solvate process. Here you see, it is obtained as intermediate product in the solvate process. Just I explain what is solvate process for the manufacture of sodium carbonate from common salt. Means manufacture of baking soda with the help of sodium carbonate and common salt, means sodium chloride, is called solvate process. Means manufacture of baking soda with the help of sodium carbonate and common salt is called solvate process. Now see, what is this sodium chloride? When sodium chloride react with ammonia gas, you see solvate process, sodium carbonate, manufacture of sodium carbonate from common salt. Right, now see, when sodium chloride react with ammonia gas and the carbon dioxide gas, we get ammonium chloride and sodium bicarbonate or sodium hydrogen carbonate. In this way, we make a manufacture of sodium hydrogen carbonate or baking soda. Beta, keep, suppose that in question paper, question is there, in which we prepare baking soda with the help of solvate process, then this method is there, that for the manufacture sodium carbonate from common salt, right now, that is sodium chloride, common salt is there, H2O liquid, means water is there, plus carbon dioxide and ammonia gas is there. And ammonia gas means carbon dioxide gas, ammonia gas is there, and the sodium chloride is there. We will get ammonium chloride and sodium bicarbonate or sodium hydrogen carbonate. Right now, in this way, we make a manufacture of baking soda. After that, now properties of baking soda means color of baking soda, their solubility, reaction with acid, with water when you heat it. Right now you see, first properties, state baking soda, already you know it, their color, you know that their state, what state there, you see white crystalline form is there. Right now, and baking soda, it is soluble in water. After that, reaction with water. But you see, baking soda, just before I told you that we use baking soda as antacid. Antacid means when amount of acid increase, to neutralize acid, we use baking soda. It means what? Baking soda generally base form. Generally, it is base. In which way you know that it is base? NaSCO3 there. Now, when it react with water, it gives hydroxide ion. And due to hydroxide ion, इट इज मिल्डली बेस, इट नॉट चेंज द फिनोलेफ्थ्रिन पेपर इन अ पिंक कलर बट माइल्डली इट इज बेस. यू सी एक्वस सोल्यूशन ऑफ सोडियम बाइकार्बोनेट इज माइल्डली एल्कलाइन, एल्कलाइन मीन्स बेस, ड्यू टू हाइड्रोलिसिस ऑफ बाइकार्बोनेट आयन. Due to hydrolysis of bicarbonate ion means when dissociation of sodium hydrogen carbonate, the dissociation of sodium hydrogen carbonate, it break in the form of sodium ion and bicarbonate ion. And when this bicarbonate react with the water means when bicarbonate hydrolysis of bicarbonate is there, it gives hydroxide ion and H2CO3. Due to presence of this hydroxide ion, it is base. After that, when you heat it, beta, when you heat the sodium bicarbonate decompose, when you heat it, sodium bicarbonate decompose, and when it decompose, it release carbon dioxide. You see, with sodium on heating of sodium bicarbonate, it decompose and gives sodium carbonate and carbon dioxide. It release carbon dioxide gas, means it evolve carbon dioxide gas. And when it react with acid again, means when sodium bicarbonate baking soda react with acid again, it decompose and it evolve carbon dioxide gas, and it release carbon dioxide gas. You see reaction when sodium bicarbonate means baking soda react with acid, we get common salt plus it release carbon dioxide gas. This is the properties of baking soda. Uses of baking soda. Uses of first, we use baking soda in bakery. We use baking soda as antacid. The many uses of baking soda is there. But in exam, don't write more. Only 2, 3, 4, maximum 4 point you write. Right now. Okay, and after that we will discuss about the POP, plaster of Paris and gypsum. Right now, more that write at least 5 uses of baking soda and 5 uses of bleaching powder. And you see, very very important question in board exam, many times it asks, and maybe it will ask that write the formula of bleaching powder CaOCl2, write the formula of baking soda, write the formula plaster of Paris. Right now, so this formula you learn it, maybe in MCQ it will ask, maybe in filling the blanks it will be asked. So all of you learn the formula, their chemical properties, their manufacture, their preparation in laboratory, and their uses. Okay, thank you.